South Indian Bank, the next generation banking, enters its 86th years of service to the nation. And what more could be much befitting than to celebrate this proud moment with our patrons, well-wishers, stakeholders, customers, staff members, and the presence of these elite dignitaries on dais. May I now request Dr. V.A. Joseph, Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of South Indian Bank, to deliver the welcome address.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a matter of great happiness that South Indian Bank has just completed 85 years of its existence. This was possible only because of the hard work of so many people, the shareholders, the customers, the employees, and the directors who are on the board on various occasions. All of them together build up this great institution. This is an occasion to remember those great people, especially these 44 people from Trichur, the visionaries, by contributing just 500 rupees each, and with an initial capital of 22,000 rupees, they started this bank. And they never wanted it to be known as a Trichur Bank or Kerala Bank. Their dream was that it should spread its wings all over South India. Perhaps that is the reason the name must have been given as South Indian Bank, because people should think of expanding. But today, much beyond their expectation, the bank has spread its wings all over the country, except Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, and Manipur. The bank's branches are everywhere. And this year, the bank proposes to open branches in Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim, and then the only state which is left will be Manipur. And also, the average age of today, our employees is just 34 for an 85-year-old organization. We do have more than 1,200 MBAs, more than 650 engineers, and more than 4,000 graduates or postgraduates working in South Indian Bank. It has become a techno-savvy with a very young personnel, qualified personnel, focusing as its main strength, service. Because today, we always say, what makes South Indian Bank different from others is the customer service, which we feel is the strength of the bank. Finally, I would like to thank all our guests, well-wishers, friends, staff, and also the representatives of print and media who are with us to bless this occasion. Thank you very much.
Well, moving on, Dr. G. Padmanabhan, who's looked upon as the pillar of Reserve Bank of India, is a powerhouse of knowledge and heads various departments such as the Department of Information and Technology, Department of Payment Systems, and Foreign Exchange Departments. We are glad that you could be here with us today, sir. May I now request you to kindly come down and offer felicitation.
Ladies and gentlemen, it must be a matter of great pride for any individual or institution to complete 85 healthy years. Given that we are living in very difficult times as far as the financial sector is concerned, the sustained progress and stability of the South Indian Bank must be a matter of great satisfaction to the management and shareholders, and most important of all, to the regulator, the Reserve Bank of India, where I come from. As many of you are aware, I hail from the state, and my association with the South Indian Bank began with a strange twist to a normally sedate story. This is one of the first head offices of the bank I got the opportunity to inspect during my earlier career in the bank, and I ran into a peculiar kind of problem, probably not experienced by any other officer of the Reserve Bank. We were days away from completing the inspection, and I had been assigned to see the most important aspect of the inspection, which is looking at the credit portfolio of the bank. The work was over, and so also the drafting of the report. Remember, we are talking about late 1980s, early 1990s, where laptops and iPads were non-existent, and we had diligently typed out paragraphs in the good old typewriter. Perhaps none of them exist today. One night, my briefcase containing this document got robbed from my hotel room. How we managed to complete this work is a boring, different story, but the twist I would like to share here is the question that the police inspector asked me, which probably is an indication of the financial literacy and the sharpness of the police in the state. He cured me whether there were any major irregularities observed in the credit portfolio of the bank thereby suggesting that if that was the case, probably the incident could have been orchestrated by the bank staff themselves. That was not the case then, I told him, and seeing the numbers year after year put out by the South Indian Bank, I can very well say that that is not the case even today. The bank is doing very well. I must congratulate one and all connected with the bank for the sustained and steady progress. And after Dr. Joseph took over, he has brought in further dynamism and competitive spirit into the working of the bank, the results of which are there for everyone to see. Similarly, my association with Mr. Guha, one of the top-notch financial professionals whom I know and I have respected over a number of years, started in a similar strange way when he happened to be the managing director of the State Bank of Travancore and I was heading the regional office in Hyderabad. I was fairly upset with the way in which the issues, particularly the customer issues relating to the foreign exchange, was being handled by the circle, and wrote a fairly tough letter to Mr. Guha. What pleasantly surprised me was the speed and seriousness with which he rectified the problem. And I stated this story because I want to make an important point here. Every one of us, whether we are individuals or institutions, do make mistakes. Those who accept the mistake when pointed out in the right spirit and take remedial actions have always progressed for the better. And this is what I like about the South Indian Bank, this great institution. They believe in no shortcuts, rightly so, because institution building has no shortcuts. My best wishes for the continued success of SIB as I look forward to its Shatabdi celebrations. Once again, I thank the bank for giving me this opportunity and wish South Indian Bank further success in the years to come. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the very special moment has arrived, and on this glorious occasion of completing 85 years of banking, South Indian Bank is proud to present and honor six eminent personalities from Kerala. These are people who whose humane touch has made our society a much better place to live in, and also they have reaffirmed the fact that it just takes one initiative to make a whole lot of difference. Ladies and gentlemen, today our chief guest, Honorable Governor of Kerala, will do the honors of awarding these majestic personalities. I also request the presence of our brand ambassador, Namada Swanda Mamukha, on the stage, please, to award the eminent personalities. Sir, can I ask you to come on stage? Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. E. Sridharan. If commuting has been made easy, we owe it to Dr. E. Sridharan, who's paved the roads and rails literally in India. He's a person whom God's own country, Kerala, can take pride in. Cochin is looking forward to the metro taking shape through the relentless commitment and dedication of Dr. E. Sridharan. Sir, congratulations on this award, and I request you to kindly come forward to collect your award. I request our Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Nikhil Kumar, to kindly give this memento of appreciation to Dr. E. Sridharan. Ladies and gentlemen, our Chairman, Omitabha Guha, will now hand over this plaque of appreciation. And the pride of South Indian Bank, our very ambassador, brand ambassador, Padma Shri Bharat Mamoti, will now hand over this cash check of rupees 1 lakh. Thank you so much, gentlemen. Once again, congratulations to Dr. E. Sridharan. Thank you. ONV എന്ന മഹാപ്രതിഭയെ മലയാളികൾക്ക് പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് പരിചയപ്പെടുത്തേണ്ട ആവശ്യമില്ല. ഒരു വട്ടം കൂടി എന്ന ഓർമ്മകൾ മെയ്യുന്ന Thirumattathettuvan Moham. These are words that kindle nostalgic memories in every Malayali's blood. He's created a revolution in Malayalam literature, portraying humanist ideas even as he embraced socialistic ideologies. Ladies and gentlemen, South Indian Bank salutes Sri O. N. Vikarup for his contributions, and may I request his daughter, Dr. S. Maya Devi, to kindly come down and accept this award on behalf of her father. I once again request our chief guest, Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Nikhil Kumar, to hand over this memento of appreciation. Dr. Maya Devi, on behalf of Sri O. N. Vikarup. Our chairman, Sri Amitabha Guha, will now hand over this plaque. ഒരു ലക്ഷം രൂപ അടങ്ങുന്ന ഈ ക്യാഷ് ചെക്ക് സമ്മാനിക്കാൻ മമ്മൂക്കോട് അഭ്യർത്ഥിക്കട്ടെ. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. V.P. Gangadharan, medicine is not just a profession but a divine calling for D.P. Gangadharan. He's a distinguished oncologist who's looked upon as a source of hope and whose primary responsibility was designing and developing the medical oncology centers like the RCC Trivandrum. Congratulations to Dr. Gangadharan, and I request your presence on stage, please. May I once again request our Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Nikhil Kumar, to hand over this memento. Our beloved chairman, Sri Amitabha Guha, will now hand over this plaque of appreciation. Our beloved brand ambassador shall now hand over the cash check of 1 lakh rupees. Affectionately, we call this gentleman the Bhavagayagan. Sri P. Jayachitran has won awards, including the national and state awards from Kerala and Tamil Nadu. His songs carry a divine touch, needless to say, leaving the listeners mesmerized. Ladies and gentlemen, this personality has a special resonance in his voice and has a reverberating effect. Congratulations, sir. I request our Honorable Governor, Governor of Kerala, Sri Nikhil Kumar, to hand over the memento. Our chairman, Amitabha Guha, will now hand over this plaque of appreciation. And Namada Swanda Mamuka will now hand over this cash check of 1 lakh rupees. Sri Innocent is one of the popular actors, and he's so popular that he's one of the most imitated actors in the Indian film industry. He's one of those very few actors who can don any role and still bring out the essence of that character. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives us great pride and privilege to honor this gentleman today, Sri Innocent. Sir, I request you to kindly come onto the stage. And Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Nikhil Kumar, will now honor Sri Innocent with this memento. Our chairman, Amitabha Guha, will now hand over this plaque of appreciation. And our brand ambassador, Bharat Mamuti, is handing over the check worth 1 lakh. Ladies and gentlemen, an exemplary entrepreneur who found the V-Guard Industries way back in 1977. He's specially known for his philanthropic activities, the noblest of them being donating his very own kidney to somebody whose life depended on it. Hats off to you, sir. We once again congratulate Sri Kochosep Chittilapalli for giving us this privilege of giving you this award. I request you to kindly come onto the stage, please. And to honor him, we have our chief guest, Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Nikhil Kumar, who will hand over this memento of appreciation. Our very own chairman, Amitabha Guha, presenting the plaque. And our beloved Mamuka, presenting the check worth 1 lakh. And ladies and gentlemen, as this happens, there is one thing that if I don't say, if I fail to say this, it's just not going to be justified. Shri Kochosep Chitlapalli has decided to give this very cash award to the cause of upliftment of the lesser privileged inmates of Madonna Chalakudem. Ladies and gentlemen, that requires a louder round of applause, and hats off to you, sir, once again. We express our hearty congratulations to the award winners. And I request our Honorable Governor, Shri Nikhil Kumar, to hand over this memento of appreciation for being a wonderful and the most handsome brand ambassador of South Indian Bank. Thank you so much. Well, and now let's move on to lighting the traditional lamp. May I request Honorable Governor Shri Nikhil Kumar to do the honors, with the other dignitaries to kindly join our brand ambassador, Shri Bharat Mamuti, Shri G. Padmanabhan, Shri Amitabh Guha, and Dr. B.A. Joseph. I now request Honorable Governor of Kerala, Shri Nikhil Kumar, to formally inaugurate the 800th branch of South Indian Bank at Arunatakara, Thrissur. And for this, I request you to formally hand over this key that represents the Arunatakara, Thrissur branch of South Indian Bank to our Managing Director and CEO, Dr. V.A. Joseph. Ladies and gentlemen, we formally inaugurate the 800th branch of South Indian Bank at Arunatakara, Thrissur. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to call upon Mr. Amitabh Guha, our chairman, South Indian Bank, to deliver the presidential address.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think it will sound quite awkward if I say I'm feeling truly privileged to be a part of this celebration. When you talk of an organization, essentially talk of the people who has made it, not the infrastructure, not the building, but the people who have made it. And I guess it becomes incumbent on me to sincerely express my gratitude to my colleagues, my former members of the board of directors, my former executives, my former staff, and the current staff who have been doing to make what is South Indian Bank today. 85 years on a standalone basis looks to be a very long period, but if you sense it from the eternal passage of time, it looks to be a common period. And in a sense, I feel the journey.